Welcome, welcome, welcome those who are watching online and those who have joined us today to worship. Welcome in the presence, welcome in the house of the Lord. I thank God for the opportunity to be up here today to coordinate the service. I thank God for the leadership for giving me this opportunity in Jesus' name. I want you to get yourself ready to get into the presence of the Lord. And to just, I just want you to stand, and give God the praise. Those who are watching online, feel free to do the same in your home, to get yourself ready to get into the presence of the Lord. Do it as if you were in the house. Stand up and pray. Join us in prayer. So today we're going to just thank God for everything that He has done for us. Thank Him for life. Thank Him for allowing us to be in the house safely. Because anything could have happened to us on our way here, but He kept us. And those who are on their way, we pray that God will bring them safely in the house. Let's pray that in Jesus' name. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank You, God, for life. Thank You for helping us, Lord God, through diverse times of trials. Thank You for this week, God. Thank You for today. Thank You for Your people. Thank You for the service. Thank You, God, that You will reign in the service today. Thank You that Your presence will be among us today. Thank You, Lord God, that we're open up our hearts to hear, to receive from You. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give You praise and we give You glory and we honor You. Hallelujah. We're just going to ask God to empty us out today. So we can receive from Him. Every load that you have today, or whatever you carry in the house today, ask God to empty you out. I pray in the name of Jesus. Father God, empty us out right now. Empty us out, oh God. That we are not, Lord God, we're not stiff. And God, we don't have any blockage, anything blocking us from receiving from You today. As we come to worship, as we come to praise Your name, and as we come to glorify You, Lord God, we give You our all today at the altar in the mighty name of Jesus. We have prayed. Keep standing. We're going to just pray for a few minutes. And then we're going to call on Pastor Emmanuel for the adult Sunday school. Hallelujah. So we're going to go to Psalms 23. And it says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He is your good shepherd. And you will not be in need of anything. Cast your burden on Him. He cares for you. Hallelujah. Let's just pray and thank God for Him being the good shepherd to us. Let us pray and thank Him. Father God, we thank You for being a good shepherd. Father God, we thank You for the promise that You give us, God, that we shall not want anything, God, that we shall not lack anything, God. So we thank You for that promise. We thank You, Lord God, for being our good God. We thank You for being our Heavenly Father, Lord God, who provide for us daily. I thank You as we give our all and our hearts to You in this moment, in Jesus' name. Verse 2, it says, He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters, and He restores my soul. He restores our soul. We thank God for restoration. Thank God today for restoration. Thank God that He's restoring you back to your faith. Thank God that He's restoring you back to the place where you was on your knees. Thank God that He's restoring your finances. Thank God that He's restoring your confidence in Him. Pray to God and thank Him for His restoration. I don't know what restoration you have to ask God for, but we're thanking Him today for restoring us, for restoring anything, God, that we have lost. We thank You this morning. Mighty name of Jesus, we thank You for Your restoration power. We thank You for restoring our health. those who are sick in their bodies. Thank you for restoration, oh God. The enemy cannot win in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are always by our side. You're in us and you're working through us and you're working for us. So we thank you for that restoration. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Three, he said, he leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. For his name's sake. Not for your sake, but for his sake. Let's just pray today that we're asking God to continue to lead us in the path of righteousness. Let's just pray that in Jesus' name. Father God, in your name we pray that you will continue to lead us, God, in the path of righteousness. Father God, for your name's sake, we thank you, Lord God, that you love us so much, that you come down, Lord God, to bless us and help us to be righteous and to direct us in that green pastures, oh God. Hallelujah, we thank you. If you're ever loving God, you're forever caring, and we thank you for the living water. We thank you for everything that you've given to us. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. For it says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Do you know what shadow is? Shadow. You're walking and you see a shadow. Just a shadow. You feel it, but it's not going to do anything to you. I said, I will fear no evil. In 2 Timothy 1 verse 7, what does it say? It says that he has not given us the spirit of fear, but what he has given us, spirit of power, love, and sound mind. Sound mind. So yet though I walk through the valley, I will fear no evil, because he has given me sound mind. In the mighty name of Jesus. So let's just thank God that he's walking with us. That he's walking with us through the valley. He's walking with us through the valley. When you go through your trials, remember that God is walking with you through your hard time, through your valley, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your voice and pray to him. Have faith and touch his garment today. And knowing that no matter what you go through, sickness cannot hold you down. Diseases cannot hold you down. Nothing, because God is walking with you. And he wants you to have no fear. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, this morning that we will have no fear, God. Because you said that you have given us a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. Sound mind to trample over the scorpion and serpents. Nothing will harm us. Nothing will touch us. Nothing will keep us down. Nothing will keep us backward. But in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Verse 5. Hey, you prepare a table before me in the very presence of my enemies. Hallelujah. And what does he do? He anoints my head with oil. And it run over. Imagine the oil running over your head. Imagine God anointing your head with oil. He's preserving you. Nothing can touch you. Nothing can stop you. Hallelujah. So let's thank God for his preservation oil. Thank you, God, this morning, God, that you anoint our head with oil, that it will run over. Thank you for preserving us this morning. Thank you for everything that you have done for us, Lord God Almighty. Thank you for making us afresh, the fresh oil of the Holy Ghost. We want to give you praise and thanks this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 6, it says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. Do you believe that or you just hear that? You have to believe the word. And when you believe the word, it begins to start to work for you. When you have faith in what you read, it begins to work for you. All the surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, not just for today, all the days of my life. And we will what? We will dwell at home, watching online, in the house of the Lord, in His presence. Never forget to rest in His presence. Rest in His arms. That's where He wants you to be. Oh, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Open up your voice right now and pray to your Maker. That tell Him that you will remain in His presence. You remain in His house no matter what you go through. Even if you're on your sick bed, you will remain faithful to Him in His house. Let's pray that in Jesus' name. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, God, that we will dwell in Your presence. We will dwell in Your house. Nothing will stop us from coming to Your house and serving in the house of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give You everything that we have this morning. And we pray, God, that we will never forget Your house. We will never forget to worship You. Hallelujah. No matter how we feel, because it's not about us, but it's about You. So we thank You. And we pray right now for the service. That God will capture the hearts of His people. That God will take their hearts, oh God, and mend it. Hallelujah, every broken heart, those who are discouraged, those who are discouraged, those who are serving and feeling discouraged, we bind that spirit right now in the mighty name of Jesus, and we cast it out, and we cast it out, and we pray, God, that there will be peace in the minds of Your people. Halikojitai, remove every fear, remove every doubt, remove everything that the enemy come to plant in the mind of Your people. And I pray for the confidence will be lifted, that they will feel confident serving You in the mighty name of Jesus. Release the worship, release the praise. We release the praise before You. Hali Gadeshka. Someone have a praise to give to You today. Someone have a praise to You to give to You today. A praise report that they will offer to You and only You. Hallelujah. We thank You as You direct the service. As we call on Pastor Emmanuel for the Sunday school lesson in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. God be praised. Amen. I'd like to thank God Almighty for life. You know, recently I just looked at the date and I was like, it's been almost 6 months since that episode and I'm still standing. Hallelujah. God is faithful. God is faithful. Amen. Hallelujah. I would like to thank the church, my pastors, everyone of these lovely faces I'm seeing right now. I thank God Almighty for our lives. I thank God for what He has started. I've said this before and I will always say this. Because He is Alpha and Omega, He doesn't start a thing that He doesn't have already finished. So if God is starting something, He knows the end. Have you forgotten? The scripture says He knows the end from the beginning. So if He has started anything with you, be rest assured that He that has started has the power to complete it. And he's not going to get to the completion and then he's looking around. Where did I put my daughter or my son? No. He's going to take you across that finish line in the mighty name of Jesus. And that is the God that we serve. Amen. Praise the Lord. I know we've been talking about discipleship, but today we are going to go into a new topic, which is one of the most important things we need to know as disciples. We are going to be talking about the Holy Spirit. Amen. I mean, it's so important that Jesus had to tell them. He says, tarry in Jerusalem for what? Until you are endued with power from on high. They stayed with him for 3 years. He taught them all he needed to teach them. He would speak in parables, meet them. This is what I meant. For those who are without, they don't understand it. That's why I speak in parables. But you that are my disciples, this is what I meant. For 3 years or 3.5 years, he kept teaching them. But despite that, you would think that was enough. No. He told them, tarry in Jerusalem until. Acts chapter 1 verse 8. He says, can we have that? Acts chapter 1 verse 8. He says, you will receive power after, not before. After the Spirit of the Lord has come upon you, not before. So, even though they were with the Word, they spent years with Jesus, they could not go ahead and do what was required of them without the Holy Spirit. So, as disciples, it is important we have that in mind, that the Spirit of God is very, very important in our walk with God. Our own spirit, God puts in our hearts, in us. But do you know that it is our spirit that agrees with the Spirit of God that says, oh, this is a child of God. Amen. So that is why it is important. The Bible says that God's Spirit in us is a light, is a candle, through which God searches the integrity, everything, the motives, why we do things. And so that is why God can say and look at someone and say, this one is not worthy. I've checked him. He's not. And he looks at David and says, this one is the man after my own heart. Why? Because he has a spirit in us. And that spirit is to teach us to make sure that the words of our mouth, the meditations of our heart are in line with what God wants. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we have John chapter 6, verse 63, please? Jesus was talking and he says, the words that I speak, they are spirits and they are life. The words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. Amen. And he says here, most assuredly, I say to you, when he says that, that's emphasis. I'm saying it without doubt. Unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, communion, you have no life in him, in you. Okay? And then also, he said there that the words I speak to you, they are spirits and they are life. In can we have Luke 24, 49, please? Luke 24, 49, New Living Translation, okay? And it says, behold, I send the promise of my Father. That's the Holy Spirit. I send the promise of my Father, just as my Father promised, but stay here in the city until the Holy Spirit comes and fills you with power. God will never send you out without first empowering you. That is the God that we serve. And because if he commissions a thing, he's committed to it. If God commissions a thing, be rest assured, you have his support. And that was why when Minister Nadine was reading Psalm 23, he talked there that he prepares the table before us in the presence of our enemies. The presence of your enemies is not enough to stop the provision of God. Amen. That they are there or whatever plans that they have, they do not have power to stop God for doing what he wants to do for his daughter and for his sons. So if there's anything God has promised you, there's no devil anywhere that's able to stop it. Because God is all powerful. He's God all by himself. And one of the good things here is, because we ask ourselves, sometimes we read the book of Acts, you see how mighty the apostles were working, and you know, someone even said that it should be called the Acts of the Holy Spirit and not the Acts of Apostles. It doesn't really matter. What happened is the Spirit of God working in men to do the will of the Father. That is what matters. And that is why we have the Spirit of God in us to lead us. We talk about the fruits of the Spirit, Galatians chapter 5. The fruits of the Spirit to help us. I mean, look at everything that it tells us that we are able, the fruits of the Spirit. This is how to relate with people around us. Patience. If you don't have that, try getting married. You are going to learn patience. Yes. You will learn patience. The Bible says concerning Jesus, even though he was his son, he learned obedience through the things he suffered. That is Jesus. Though he were his son, he learned obedience through the things he suffered. And so that is why the Spirit of God is there. Jesus was teaching them. He said, look, I will give you once I go, you will get the promise of the Father. That's the Holy Spirit. And he will be inside of you. He will teach you. He will, most of us talk about, yes, the scriptures is inspired word of God. Who inspired it? It's the Holy Spirit. God through his Spirit. And every time something glorious wants to happen, remember the creation? He said that the earth was formed, was without void. Everything was dark. And then what? The Spirit of God moved over it and God spoke. When there's a combination of the Spirit of God and the Word of God, things, there's transformation. That is why we can't just say, that I'll just be praying. You need the Spirit of God. You need the Word of God. It's the Word of God that makes a way for us. Jesus is the Word. Amen. And it says, as we hear the Word, that is when our faith is built. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. So he told them, look, I know you've been with me for 3.5 years, and I've told you, you need to be my witnesses, but you have to tarry in Jerusalem. Stay in the city until you are endued with power from on high, until the Spirit of God comes. So when the Spirit comes, then you receive a power. Then you will not be afraid. I mean, these were people who were hiding. They were hiding because they went into hiding because Jesus had been arrested. He had been killed, and they were afraid for their own lives. That's why they were hiding in the upper room. But the moment the Spirit came upon them, came boldness. That is why that scripture tells us, I have not given you a spirit of fear. So if there's fear manifesting around you, it is not coming from God. What he has given us is a spirit of love, power, and of a sound mind. The Bible tells us that perfect love casts out fear. If you allow God's love inside of you, fear cannot stay in that same place. We're talking about the fear. And what does the fear do? It torments. Fear torments us. Love doesn't. Love eases the tension, releases all those anxiety from inside of us. It heals us. Amen. Praise the Lord. And it is very, very important that for us to be able to walk as disciples, we walk in line with the leading of the Holy Spirit. Because we didn't call ourselves. Even though we decided to let so many things go and become Christ's disciples, we still need to walk in line with what is acceptable. And that's why we have the Holy Spirit. The Bible tells us about that there is no man knows the heart of a man save the spirit of that man. In the same way, no man knows the heart of God except the Spirit of God. And so, when we are in relationship with the Spirit of God, we are able to know that whatever I'm being led to do by the Spirit of God is in line with what is acceptable by God. Because it is important. Remember what Apostle taught us? That when you don't wait for God's timing, it's mercy that goes ahead. But if you go with God's timing, His presence goes ahead. His favor goes ahead of you. And then when things happen, you know that God is there for you. And then so sometimes when we go and just by our feelings, His mercy speaks for us, yes. You know, but we'd rather have the favor, right? We'd rather take the favor of God. Amen. To go ahead of us and pave way. Amen. The commanded one. You know, the one that preserves us. So that when He goes ahead of us, what did the Bible say? It says, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion for the time to favor her. Yea, the set time has come. Did you get that? Mercy first, and then what? Favor comes. And we have every day, God's mercy is being renewed concerning us. Every day. So the moment you wake up, you receive new mercies. Not because we are good or overnight something great happened to us. No. We are still the same person who is still living in malice, who is still struggling, you know. Probably you wake up, that neighbor, you don't greet your neighbor. Not good. Not good at all. You know, God expects us to live and show love. He says, this is how they will know you are my disciples, when you love one another. That is you showing that you are a disciple of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. And it's very important for us to know. I love, you can read John chapter 14, the whole chapter. Because most times people will say, yes, Paul really taught us many things about the Holy Spirit. But Jesus had already started it in John chapter 14, telling us that, hey, the Spirit of God, when He comes, He will comfort you. He will remind you of everything that I have taught you. That is a part of it that I usually use. If I have something, my keys or anything, I misplace, I don't know where I put it, I tell myself, Holy Spirit, I need you right now. I need you to remind me. Jesus said that you will remind us. And believe me, just within some few minutes, sometimes I might just go to sleep and then I just get it. What I've been looking for, I find. So the Holy Spirit is there to comfort us. He's there to build us, to be able to do, to build capacity in us, to be able to do what God wants us to do. Amen. So it's important for the next few weeks, every Sunday, we'll be looking at the Holy Spirit. And some people struggle. The Holy Spirit is not God. I don't know. Your spirit is you, right? So if it's God's spirit, that is God. Amen. So let's not allow ourselves to be deceived. And one of the good things about the Holy Spirit is also it helps to comfort, to inspire us, to encourage us. When we find ourselves in places or in situations, and you know your neighbors, you can pray if they have the Spirit of God. For me, I use it a lot. You know, after coming out of coma, and one of the things I would say is, God, your word says that if you have the Spirit of God in us, it will quicken our mortal bodies. And so I say, God, I call for a quickening of my mind, my spirit, my health, my body. With the Spirit of God inspiring you, that is when you are transformed until we become the image of Christ. Is that Spirit telling you? See, one of the things the Spirit will be telling us is pointing out where we are wrong. It will tell us it's so much like us to feel like the problem is every other person, but we are fine. It's so easy for us to say that. I mean, everybody has issues. but me, I'm good. No. One of the things that helps us with the Holy Spirit is it whispers to us. It tells us something. I remember I was just saying to Prophetess Melissa and Dwayne yesterday, and I was telling them that when I was in the rehab, there was a guy I saw, and I was like, the way he looks, he might be one of those murderers and everything. I mean, the man in me was judging. And I'm like, you know, and very shortly after that, the Holy Spirit was like, okay, let's look at it. Who looks like the crazy one? I said, no, not me. I look fine. Because when the coma happened, I had so much issues with cognitively, with balance, and so they had to put braces on me. Because I might sleep in one bed and wake up in another bed. So who looks crazy now? The Holy Spirit was asking me. And I'm like, oh, okay, I give up. You sleep on one bed, you wake up in another bed. Who is crazy now? So we are not called to condemn. The Spirit of the Lord will tell you immediately when you want to condemn. No, this is wrong. One of the ways we grow in the Spirit is when we are told the things we have done wrong. Go before God and say, God, I am sorry. Have mercy. Holy Spirit, help me. That is one of the ways we grow in the Spirit. And of course, the Spirit helps you to understand the Word, and the Word helps you to build faith that will help you. Amen. So it is very, very important for us. And of course, we know Acts chapter 1, verse 8, you will receive power after the Spirit of God, not before, after the Spirit of God comes on you. So when the Spirit of God comes on you, of course, power is made available for us. So when, you know, Peter was going to pray and he saw the man by the gate, by the beautiful gate, and he was trying to ask for money. And he says, see, silver and gold I don't have, but what I have, I will give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, stand up. And they respond. I'll tell my daughters, see, if anything appears to you in your dream, just call the name of Jesus. Because they will run. They will run. They can't bear that name. We have been given a name, the name, that's above every other name, no matter what those other names are called. It is only the surrender to one name, the name of Jesus. And the moment you call the name of Jesus, I'll tell them. So, I saw something in my dream. Okay, what did you see? Did you call the name of Jesus? Yes. And what happened? They ran away. They will run. Of course they will run. They always run because we've been given one name that's above every other name. At that name, they bow. Amen. And I don't know whatever situation you're going to, through, as you call on the name of Jesus, they bow in the mighty name of Jesus. And when they bow to Jesus, it means everything that now happens is what God wants in your life. Your life now starts to be a reflection of the word he has spoken concerning you. Amen. And that is one of the things we should, or the reasons why we should get closer to the Spirit of God. He knows the heart of the Father. And so he will tell you, that route, no. This, no. I was just saying, even while coming today, that because we are human, we get aggrieved sometimes. People say there are very, very bad people in the world, and they say hurtful things, you know? And then you get affected in a way. You understand? You need to deal with it before it takes root inside of you. You need to just say, God, Holy Spirit, help me with this. Help me with this. I know by my own strength I can't do this. Paul says, by strength shall no man prevail, but we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. And so we can tell ourselves, God, help me. Holy Spirit, right now I need that fruit of patience. I need that fruit of patience. I need that fruit of long suffering to be able to bear this so that I'm not saying contrary to what God wants. That love, that fruit of the Spirit of love will be established inside of me. That I will have a wellspring of love inside of me to be able to answer every man according to what is proper and acceptable. That the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be pleasing in your sight, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. That is all you need to do with the Holy Spirit. I'm not saying in all, along your journey. Speak to the Spirit of God. Let the Spirit of God lead us. Let him tell us when we are wrong. Let him tell us, okay, here you are terribly wrong. And then you go. And that's one of the things God loved about David. David understood when he messed up. He would just turn to the Father, look, I'd rather fall into your hands than in the hands of my enemies, because I know you are plenteous in mercy. He will go down. That is why God says, I love this kind of heart. And that's why this was someone rejected by even his own family. God says, look, they don't know you. Guess what? I'm going to make you my king. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sorry. Okay, I want us to bow down our heads and we're going to pray. All we're going to pray for is, God, help me in my walk with the Holy Spirit. Can we just pray that prayer right now? Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, thank you for the gift of the Father, the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. Holy Spirit, we ask that you help us to grow in God, grow in grace, grow in faith, grow, O Lord God Almighty, knowing fully well what is acceptable to the Father. Lead us, Lord God Almighty. Help our hearts to be able to bear it when you correct us, so that we walk in love. We walk as is acceptable to the Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Pastor Emmanuel. No problem. No problem. Amen. Thank you. Let us clap for Jesus. Praise and worship. Please be my of the time. Amen.
Amen. Can we be up and standing, because we serve a big God? Amen.
Amen.
All the days of Elijah, declaring the words of the Lord. These are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And these are the days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sore. See, we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and the trumpets calling in your voice. Is it to believe? Out of Zion's hill, salvation. Behold, he comes. Salvation. Behold, he comes. He saw the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, building the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the field as white in the world. So we are the laborers in your vineyard. We pay the way of the Lord. Jehovah, there's no God like 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 Jehovah. And you say there's no God like Jehovah, 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 no God. Nobody, no God, no God, no God, oh, no God, no, nobody, no, no God, no God, no, no God, nobody like him, nobody like him, nobody like him.
My prayer.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have an awesome God. Amen. It's time for testimony. Amen. We've been hearing a lot of testimonies of restoration, financial restoration, spiritual restoration, boldness in the spirit, and I'm sure it's our portion, healings. So those who have a testimony, please stand on my left side so that you can share your testimony, strengthen and edify others. Amen? Amen. Let's clap for Jesus as our sister is coming.
Hallelujah. I'm sorry, Minister Yarnell. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I've got a testimony. Hey, falsehood. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I've got a testimony. Church, I want to give God praise. I want to give God all the glory. He deserves it. Last Sunday, I was struggling. I was battling to come to church. It was between the hospital or church. And I messaged Apostle. I said, Apostle, I know I am on my monthly cycle, but I'm bleeding out of the ordinary. And I am between the decision of the hospital or church, but I'm just for church. So I'm going to come church because I know the God in whom I serve. In the midst of my weakness and everything, Apostle said, come with the family. I said to my husband, I'm going to church because I'm just for church. I'm going there. I'm not going to the hospital because God did not give us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, of love, and of a sound mind. And I know the God in whom I serve. So I came to church, and I sat in the back. An apostle was preaching. I mean, our man of God, the apostle of the house, is so simple. He preached in the midst of storm and in the midst of certain situation. He's just so relaxed. Because you have to have confidence in God. Know the God you serve and the God you call upon and the God in whom you believe in. And I sat there and I was so weak, just blood flowing out of me like water. I tell Isaac, call Sister Nicole. I said, Tata Nicole, just hold me. My husband was beside me. They were praying. And I don't know when Pastor Jonah came over or who called him, but he came and then he prayed. I knew, during that time when both of them were there praying, something left me. Something just left my body. And I was just there as weak as I am, coming into agreement. And I felt so light, so different. At the end, after Apostle message, he came and he laid hand and he said, I'm doing the finishing up here. You know, so I give God thanks. When I went home, the bleeding just stopped. Everything just ended. I give God thanks.
Amen. Amen. We thank God. We thank God. Amen. Sister Nadine, can we clap for Jesus?
Amen, church. I just want to give God thanks. I went to 2 stores yesterday. And instead of me, I went to buy some things. And instead of me paying for it, they said, do you want it for free? And I'm like, for free? They're like, yeah. I'm like, okay. I went to this other store and the person's like, okay, I'll give it to you for free. I'm like, huh? The grace in this house is too much, oh. So that's my testimony.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm grateful this morning to be here. And I want to say thank you to the church. Especially those who pray for people. The past week, my mom was not well back home, and she came from the interior and came to the city. She was taken to the hospital, and by the grace of God, God intervened, and she's doing well now. So I want to be grateful. The next thing I want to let the church know is I want to be grateful to the church for all these years. From 2020 ending, I came to this church. Pastor Johnson had been there. When he didn't see me, he would check on me. He would call me. I've been going through a lot of stuff. And I want to be grateful to the church for that. Amen. And you've been praying for us. I've been grateful to the church. Multiplication year, we try to see if we can get some certification. We went through those process. But still, we believe that we are here in Canada to do some work, but Quebec is a challenge a little bit for us, for our profession. So I have an opportunity to travel to Calgary, and I'll be changing my location. So I will ask the church to pray along with me as I go, and this is my church, and you are my family, and we'll be in connection. By the end of this month, I will be in Calgary by the grace of God. Thank you so much.
Amen.
I love my brother. Good morning, good morning, good afternoon. First, I want to give thanks to God and, of course, the church, the people. The entire family became very sick. It was one after the other. And, man, life was being sucked out of me. It was something, but God's strength, you know, it's amazing. But I just want to thank every single person who took the time to pray, to check in, even if I didn't respond. I'm sorry, but it was just, you know, but I, you know, that's unity. And I was listening to Pastor Emmanuel on my way here, and I went to visit my dad yesterday. And he's in a, like, you know, he had an aneurysm, so we praise God for his life because that's a miracle. My dad, we had to place him in a home and in a center, and that's that place where he is it's excluded from everybody. It's all those who have cognitive problems. I was telling him last night, I got there and my dad wasn't in his room, so I had to go looking for him. But they all sleep in different people's beds. It's you know, it's, so I'm looking for my dad, and I'm like, you know. And, but I just want to share this testimony is that in the system, everything takes time. Everything takes time. By the time we made a decision to sign off the papers, I'm telling you, it wasn't easy. And it's still not easy. They said it would take about many, many months, up to a year to get the call. 4 weeks later, we got the call to place him. And I knew at that moment that God was working. Because when things happen, bam, 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 you know God's involved. But the chaos that it brought, man, it was something. But I'm just saying this to say that when I went to visit him, you know, I was just grateful for life. Just grateful that we're alive, that we have breath, that we're in our right minds. And if there's a time in this moment that we have to rise up as a church, it's now, meaning praying for people. So I'm so grateful for all of you who prayed, because I think it was yesterday I was like, it's in your weakness that you know who God is, but it's in your weakness who you know your people are. So I just want to say thank you. I love you. To Dwayne, who took care of me, my God, like, really. We took care of each other, but, you know, I just wanted to highlight that because he really took good care of me, and I'm just grateful. So thanks, everybody. I'm back, and I'm telling you, it's a new season. It's a new season. It's a new season that whatever is inside of you is going to burst open. Whatever is inside of you is going to burst open. That whatever you've been praying for, the heavens are open. That whatever you've been waiting for, the time has come. The time has come. Something is going to happen if you just tap into it. And if you go back and, I'm sorry, if you go back and listen to the preaching of last weekend, the walls have been destroyed, but the walls are being rebuilt. But you choose how you want to rebuild them. Either you stay the same or you change. And this year is the year of multiplication, continuous. And I'm believing that the church will increase in souls. I believe that the church will go to another dimension. I believe that everything that God has declared for this church shall be manifested. That every plan of the enemy that is trying to disgrace and bring down this church, that nothing will come against it in the name of Jesus. That if you're a partaker of Wittram, know that you shall be blessed and that you shall multiply. And that the worries that you have, just give them to the Lord. We're blessed. We're blessed. And we're highly favored. I'm telling you, man, I'm back and it's coming with fire.
Hallelujah. Let's clap for Jesus. Let's clap. Amen. You're back. You're back.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Today is a special day for me because 5 years ago, It was on a Sunday morning. We're getting ready to come to church. And I was heavily pregnant for Josie. And it was, we're getting ready to come to church. And thank God everything went well. And before service was over, I had given birth to Josie. And why am I testifying today is that Josie came as a big surprise for me. I knew I was done. And I had Rose and Manuela. They have about 4 or 5 years different. And she just appeared. But I'm telling you, God knows what he's doing. Because she came during her pregnancy, revived my spiritual life. Every night, I could hear the baby tell me, Mama, get up and let's pray. Wow. Every night. Even when I gave birth to her, she would still wake me up. And later on, Joseph followed. So I just knew that I was in a journey with God, with these kids. And what I want to say is that, why are you guys laughing?
I don't know.
Okay, it is well. So what I want to say is that God knew what he had to bring out of me through this child. She's so gentle, so peaceful. She wouldn't argue for anything. She's just grateful to be alive. So I see that, and God speaks to me through her. And later on, Joseph came, and that was another journey. So I really just want to say thank you to the Lord. And I'm grateful for these children. I knew I would have just one, but today I'm like, it's okay. Just do what you have to do. Thank you.
Amen. 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 Thank God for the life of Jose. Amen.
Hello, church. I just want to say thank you to God for his grace and his mercy. Because I haven't been in trouble with the law for a while, and a couple of weeks ago I got a ticket, okay, for supposedly going through the stop sign. So I went with my mother the other day. We checked out to make a payment arrangement, and basically I found out another ticket that I had pending since 2014. Wow. And I just want to thank God. He's looking out for me in ways. I know I have to pay a ticket, but I would have never found out this ticket, and I could have ended up in jail. That's what the guy said, was saying, you're lucky, it's about $1,255 I got to pay back, but I made an arrangement for both of them, and I'm just grateful to God, and just want to say thank you.
Amen, amen, amen. The Bible says that you will be looking with your eyes. In Psalm, the Bible says that you will see the things that almost struck you, but it will not touch you. You will see, but it will not touch you. Yeah. That's what the Bible says. And many testimonies we've seen, we've listened here, is that you've seen what could have been the thing, but it didn't touch you. Amen. One other word is that don't be afraid that you can die or someone can kill you. Because Pastor Emmanuel was sharing about the spirit of fear. And God gave us the spirit of power, love, and sound mind. And the power of life and death lies in the tongue. One man cannot kill another man if that man doesn't allow this man to kill him. So if we just stand with God, God only can tell us, okay, it's over, come back. But not another man. Not another man. Amen. So we'll just rise and pray for these testimonies corporately, that the Lord is doing a great work. He's multiplying us. Debt has been paid. Things have been given favor. Sister Nadine got favor. A lot of healing. Our sister got healed. And the Lord is doing great things. So let us pray and thank God for the testimonies. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Your favor, your grace, and your mercy is upon our lives. Thank you for the multiplication. Thank you because what the enemy thought to do in our lives, he failed. And we say that the agenda of the enemy upon the life of each one of us has burned with the fire of Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you for the healings. We thank you for the testimonies. We thank you for the favor that we are carrying. And within your power and your grace, thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Thank you. So we are going to collect our offerings. There are envelopes in the back of the chairs. And the usher also will help you if you need envelopes. Amen. The choir, please.
Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
Thank you as your children bring their tithe into your house. Lord, let the blessings of God for tithing be established. We speak your word over their life and release them mightily by the power of your spirit. Excellent God, that as they give, they will not suffer any reproach. They won't suffer any lack. In the name of Jesus, in this covenant season of provision, provide for them abundantly and cancel debt. By the power of your spirit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for those who have given their offerings and those who have given online. We receive it with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen. Can we celebrate Jesus?
Amen. It's time for the announcements. So we'll have the announcements projected. Amen.
If it is your first time at Witch Room, we welcome you. Thank you for joining us here today. And we're about to go into the announcements. On May 31st, Witch Room's youth ministry, we are, is going to be having... Good afternoon, everyone. And if it is your first time at Witch Room, we welcome you. Thank you for joining us here today. And we're about to go into the announcements. On May 31st, Wittrim's youth ministry, we are, is going to be having a youth activity. And to join this youth activity, you should reach out to Minister Adam or Minister Kimberly. And also take note that every Sunday at 8 p.m., there is intercession. And so to join this, once again, you could reach out to Minister Kimberly or Minister Adam. For School of Ministry Level 1 students, courses will start on May 25th. To join, you can reach out to Deaconess Mary to get further information. To all of my singles, Wittrim's annual singles retreat is going to be taking place this year on May 18th. If you are interested in joining, you can reach out to Minister Nadine. For all of those who are interested in getting baptized, you can reach out to Pastor Johnstone for further information. Get your passports ready. We are heading to New Jersey. Global Power Ministries is having their annual leadership conference, and this is going to take place between May 20th to the 24th. So if you're interested in joining, reach out to Pastor Johnstone for further information, such as transportation or information on the pricing, but definitely you will not regret going. LCA, which stands for Love Conquers All by Prophetess Melissa, is going to be having a session of evangelization. This is going to take place on May 4th. Starting at 3 p.m., there's going to be prayers and teachings at Wittrim, and then it's going to progress to outside. So if your heart has been meaning to figure out how to evangelize and you've been interested in doing that, this is your moment to join. So you can reach out to Prophetess Melissa for more information. Wittrim's youth ministry, We Are, has partnered with two businesses, one being Ocut Barbershop, and this partnership allows for all the youth of Wittrim to receive reduced fare on their haircuts. So reach out to Minister Adam for more information. The second business that We Are has partnered with is Beauty Institute As God Made Me. This partnership allows for the youth of Wittrim to receive $10 off at any beauty service that they'll receive. This establishment is at 6000 Grand Prairie Boulevard. You can reach out to Minister Adam or Minister Kimberly for more information. For all of my business women, the Beauty Institute As God Made Me has a business coaching program, which is very interesting. And so if you're interested in joining, they are partnering with us to offer $20 off on your first month joining them. So for more information, you can reach out to Minister Adam or Minister Kimberly. Wittrim's Women's Ministry is going to be having a prayer meeting this Tuesday at 7 p.m. Be sure to join. It is a blessed moment that we all partake in. It's just an hour long from 7 to 8 p.m. For more information on how to join or to be joined into the Women's Forum, you can reach out to Pastor Colombo. Here at Wittrim, we have exciting news. We're having our first leadership conference. This conference is called Excellent Leadership, and it's going to be taking place between October 30th to November 2nd. For all of our Canadian residents, the registration fee is only $200. And for those who are coming from abroad, you can register at the Gloryland Mission website. And for all of those who are coming from out of Canada, you can register at the Gloryland Mission website. For everyone who's been interested in deliverance, School of Deliverance just started a new semester. Although classes started on April 12th, you can still reach out to Deaconess Mary to be included. They are open to more registrations. Honestly, deliverance class goes deep in what tools you can get and how to be more effective, how you could use deliverance in your own personal life. And so if you are interested, take note that these classes take place over a course of 5 weeks, every Friday at 6:30. However, the last class will take place on a Saturday. Thank you so much, and a big welcome to all of Wittrim's new workers. Thank you so much for joining a team. There will be a special training for you on May 4th between 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. So if you're interested in finding out more information, you can reach out to your head of department or Pastor Johnstone. And a note to all of the head of departments, for those who are in your team that have not gone through training, you can give the list to Pastor Johnstone, or just new people who just got into your team, you can also add them to the list as well. Thank you. We welcome you to join us every Wednesday from 5:30 to 7:30. This is our midweek Bible study where we go deeper in the Word. If unfortunately you are not able to be there in person, you can follow along online, whether on YouTube at Witch Room Canada or on our Facebook page, Witness of the Truth International Mission Canada. So, hope to see you. The men's ministry gathers every Monday at 7:30 p.m. to join in prayer. If you are interested in joining them, you can reach out to Deacon Donald. Every Sunday, Witch Room has two services. The first one being the French service, which starts at 9 a.m. and finishes at 11 a.m. And then the second one being the English service, which commences at 11:30 a.m. and finishes at 1:30 p.m. We would love to fellowship with you and praise our Lord Jesus together. So if you can join, it will be a blessing. If you or any of your children are interested in taking music lessons, singing lessons, or songwriting lessons, Le Royaume Music School is offering courses, one-on-one, and group sessions. You can reach out to Brother Jephthah or myself for any additional information. Thank you so much for listening to the announcements. If there was anything you so happened to have missed, you can reach out to Deaconess Mary. Apart from that, I pray that you have a blessed service and that you have a deeper encounter with the Holy Spirit. May you be blessed and prosperous in this year of multiplication.
Hi, everyone. Okay. I have something to ask you today. I want you to look around the room and see what we have, that we should do this year in this church. Those who already know the answer, please don't say anything. Just look, take a look around, like just a quick second. Cheers. Yay! That's it. We are doing, turn around, we're doing a fundraising. I don't hear any clapping. Amen. We're doing a fundraising for the chairs this year. As you notice that the chairs are different colors, different shape, and we need to get new chairs this year. As Ezra 7 verse 27 says, like he was glorifying the Lord because the king was beautifying the house of the Lord. So that is our job this year, is to beautify the house of Witchrim. Amen? All right, so the price that we saw was $115 per chair in Canada. And that the total would be $34,500 for 300 chairs. But you guys look so sad. But there's good news. $25 per chair, for 300 chairs would be $12,500. We're, yes. People already started donating this morning. Someone said, oh, I want to be the first one to donate, and she did it. Amen. the posters will be up there. What I forgot to mention this morning is, you'll see that you'll go to glorylandmission2020@gmail.com. But when you do that, please just write cheers so it's not confusing, so Deaconess Mary would know what the deposit is for, okay? It's going to be posted up there. If you have any question, you can come see me, see Deaconess Mary. That's it. It's up to you now. It's out there. We didn't want to keep it to ourselves to just ask people around 1-1 to donate. We wanted to make sure that the house is doing it together in unity. Amen? God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Nadine.
Amen. Let me say something on that, which I did in the French service. Praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, let's celebrate Jesus. So this is an initiative of the concept of it is from the logistics. So some weeks ago, I was praying here. I was with Pastor Johnstone, and I just said to him, I just saw, you know, sometimes you can be in a situation, but it's okay. But when God starts calling attention, I just saw it, and I said, Don't you see that we have different kinds of chairs in the church? And he said, yeah. I said, we need to start asking God to help. We need to buy a new set and have the same kind of chairs everywhere. We're discussing, it was on a Tuesday. Also, we're discussing that. And then that same week on Friday, I got a text from Minister Nadine. And she said, Apostle, I want to ask something. God has been laying in my heart that we should get the chairs for the church. Can we bring it to the church for other people to contribute? That's what happened. And I said, yeah, that's awesome. So in other words, it was a confirmation. Because I was talking with Pastor Johnson, just the two of us, and I didn't have any intention. I didn't think about bringing it to the church for that. But then when she brought it, I knew that that was the Lord. What am I saying? God, like we were teaching on Wednesday Bible studies. Those who don't join Bible studies, I encourage you to join Bible studies. We're teaching how God provides for his church. We saw how they were building the temple. It is the people who brought the things. Everything that was used to build the temple, the people brought it. And we saw that God also told Moses, he said, I've given you Bezalel, Oholiab, with skills and abilities to help to build. Which means that when God brings you into the house of God, it is our responsibility to combine, to join, to build the house of God. And God loves a cheerful giver. Not under pressure. Just be free. Free in your heart. Whatever it is. And sometimes those are the initiatives I was sharing. Like if you enter my office there, you see there, I have a new, those who have been there recently, I know there are many of you who have not been there for the last 7 months. That's okay. We are still blessed. If you've been there recently, I have a brand new chair there. And that was somebody, a sister came, who was counseling and deliverer, said, Apostle, I'm going to buy you this chair. And she bought. Another one came and saw the chair and said, you have a brand new chair, I'm going to buy a new table. And yes. And he said, of course, I always choose the best. So I've reached that many. If you want to buy me something, I will choose the best anyway. Because my God is up there. Praise the Lord. What am I sharing this? We have, and a brother met me and said, you see the entrance of the church there, that place there, somebody said, give me an estimate on how to fix it. That entrance there. That is how the house of God is built. You must not be told. Initiatives. You see what has to be done. You have the ability. You do it. But I always say, don't borrow to give to God. Give to God as the Lord has blessed you. Amen. The Bible says, every man as the Lord has blessed him should give. Amen. If you are borrowing to give, borrowing is not the blessings of the Lord. You give as the Lord has blessed you. Praise the Lord. So, brethren, I want to encourage everybody. I mean, the 12,000, she's saying we had to do some research. We're getting the chairs from China. So the 12,000 includes buying the chairs and then the shipping. Praise the Lord. Amen. Because getting a year, I don't see how we put $35,000 for chairs. So that's why we have 1 month. Let's see what we can do. If God lays in somebody's heart, you can decide to say, I'm just buying all the 300 chairs. What is 12,000? It's nothing. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes. So if God lives in your heart, do it. But listen, there is no yoke on your neck. There is no rope on your neck. Yeah, we don't pressure people to give. Give, and we don't tell you to borrow to give. Give as the Lord has blessed you. Whatever you can give is acceptable in any form. But let's collectively join to build the house of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. God bless you. Let's celebrate Jesus.
Hallelujah. Is there anyone visiting us for the first time? Est-ce qu'il y a quelqu'un qui nous visite pour la première fois? Vous pouvez lever votre main. Amen. S'il y a personne, there is no one, so the choir will lead us into the ministration song. Amen. Can we clap for Jesus?
Amen. So the song we want to minister is More Than Gold. We pray that as you listen to us minister, that this will bless your heart. Amen.
My soul longs for you forever and ever, yes. This heart beats for you, for as the deep as for water, so my soul longs for you forever and ever, yes. This heart beats. I've got something more than gold. I'll tell it to the world. Jesus is more than gold. Something more, something more than gold. I've got something more than gold. Something more than gold. I've got something.
Spirit of the Lord.
got something more than gold.
Praise, because we've got something more than gold. We've got something more than gold. Hallelujah. Can you give us verse 2? Verse 2? Sister Alice, verse 2. It's such an honor. Hallelujah. Okay. More than gold? More than gold, more than gold. I've got something?
I've got something.
Something more.
Something more than gold.
Something more.
Something more than gold.
Spirit of the Lord.
Spirit of the Lord within me.
It's more than. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's do our declaration for 2024. Hallelujah. Amen. At the count of three, one, two, with your hands up. By the grace of God, I declare 2024 to be a year of continuous multiplication and greatness in the Lord. This 2024, I dwell in the secret place of the Lord. Therefore, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Therefore, no evil or affliction shall be upon my household in Jesus' name. This year, as I receive the word of God into my spirit, I am transformed into the image of Christ. Be fruitful in all good works and move from glory to glory by the Spirit of God. I receive great illumination in the eyes of my understanding to know and manifest in my calling. The riches of my inheritance and the greatness of His power working in me to become great in the kingdom of God. My children shall grow in the way of the Lord. They shall be like olive plants round my table and walk in greatness. In Jesus' name, I believe my spiritual life, my health, my business, my projects, my education, my career, my ministry, my relationships shall be in continuous multiplication this year. Amen. Clap for Jesus. Amen. You may have your seats. Hallelujah. I would like to thank the apostle and his wife, Pastor Faith, for another opportunity to share the word today. Hallelujah. Amen. So we'll dive in straight. The title I named for the word today is simply Looking at the bigger picture.
Donc pour la parole d'aujourd'hui, le titre c'est regarder à un plus grand but ou image.
Amen. Amen. Why did I name it looking at the bigger picture?
Pourquoi est-ce qu'il a intitulé regarder à une plus grande image?
Nehemiah had a goal.
Nehemie avait un but.
He had a vision.
Il avait une vision.
It didn't matter what the obstacle that came his way, he kept on.
Peu importe les obstacles qu'il a eu sur son chemin, il a continué.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Can the team give me Nehemiah 1 verse 3?
Donc
Nehemiah 1 verse 3. Alléluia.
Amen.
This is where Nehemiah hears of the bent down fences. It says, they said to me, things are not going well for those who return to the province of Judah. They are in great trouble and disgrace. Continue on. The wall of Jerusalem has been torn down and the gates have been destroyed by fire. Amen.
Amen.
So the key thing I want us to take there simply is that he got bad news.
Non, la chose de clé c'est quoi? C'est que Néhémie a reçu une mauvaise nouvelle.
A lot of times we don't get good news, maybe from home.
La majeure partie du temps, nous ne recevons pas de bonnes nouvelles parfois.
Especially those of us who are from far away.
Surtout pour nous qui venons de loin.
Amen.
Amen.
And what happened? Let's look at verse 4.
Bon, on va aller au verset 4. Vous suivez en français.
Yes, verse 4 says, when I heard this, I sat down and wept. In fact, for days I mourned, fasted and prayed to the God of heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is that thing that pushes you to God and not away from him?
Donc, quelle est cette chose-là qui t'éloigne de Dieu et qui te fait t'enfuir de sa présence?
That's not what I said. What is that thing that pushes you to God?
Donc, quelle est cette chose-là qui t'amène vers Dieu
and doesn't pull you away from God?
Et qui ne te retire pas de Dieu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because what happened? Can I have the verse? Don't take it away. The same verse I gave you, verse 4, Nehemiah 1. It says, I mourned, which means he had that moment of sadness.
Donc, il s'est endeuillé, il avait ce moment de tristesse.
But what did it push him to do?
Mais qu'est-ce que ça l'a poussé à faire?
He fasted.
Il a jeûné.
And he prayed.
Et il a prié.
To the God of heaven.
Au Dieu.
I pray challenges will push you to prayer and fasting in Jesus' name.
Je prie. Amen. Que les défis vont vous amener à la prière et au jeûne au nom de Jésus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So like Nehemiah has a burden and is big. So basically, Nehemiah, he had a burden simply because the fences had been destroyed.
Donc, Néhémie avait un fardeau parce que les murailles avaient été détruites.
When we read on further, you understand that Nehemiah was the cupbearer.
Donc, quand nous lisons plus loin, on va découvrir que Néhémie était l'échanson du roi.
He was close to the king.
Il était proche au roi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. And the Bible says he did not only fast and pray. Can we go to 5?
Et la Bible nous dit qu'il n'a pas seulement jeûné et prié.
He said, then I said, this is Nehemiah saying, O Lord God of heaven, the great and, next, awesome God who keeps his covenant of unfailing love with those who love him and obey his commands. Amen?
Amen.
Go on to the next. Listen to my prayer. Look down and see me praying night and day for your people to Israel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have prayed, you have fasted.
Vous avez prié, vous avez jeûné.
Apostle has declared that it's the month of blessings.
L'apôtre a déclaré que c'est le mois de bénédiction.
We've had many testimonies of those who are being blessed, receiving money which canceled out their debts.
Nous avons reçu beaucoup de témoignages des gens qui ont reçu de l'argent qui ont pour l'annulation de leur dette ou pour payer leur dette.
I just want to remind you that your testimony is on the way in the mighty name of Jesus
Christ.
Je veux
juste vous rappeler it says, que votre témoignage est en chemin au nom de Jésus-Christ.
He prayed night and day.
Il a prié nuit et jour.
Which meant he persisted.
Qui veut dire quoi, c'est qu'il était persistant.
He insisted.
Il a insisté.
He was basically saying, even if the enemy might have succeeded for now.
Non, il était pratiquement en train de dire que même si l'ennemi a réussi jusqu'à présent.
I know even if the walls have fallen, they can be rebuilt again. Amen. I pray that somebody's wall is going to be rebuilt today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Même si les murs sont effondrés, je sais que les murs peuvent être rebâtis au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Non, la prière, c'est que si vos murailles ou quelque chose s'est effondré dans vos vies, ça sera rebâti au nom de Jésus.
Amen. I've spoken to many in the church who were not in the mood of fasting, and they woke up in the morning and the Lord told them, fast.
Donc, il s'est adressé à plusieurs personnes à l'église. Ils n'avaient pas envie de jeûner, mais le Seigneur leur a dit, jeûnez, et ils ont obéi.
Trust me, I love my breakfast. Eh? Hallelujah. Amen. But that's just to say that even though I love my breakfast, sometimes you gotta sacrifice.
Donc, le pasteur aime son petit déjeuner, mais juste pour vous dire que même si vous aimez votre petit déjeuner, vous devez faire un sacrifice.
When the Lord leads you, obey, even if you don't understand.
Quand le Seigneur vous dirige, obéissez, même si vous ne comprenez pas.
Psalm 64, verse 1.
Le psaume 61, verset...
Just take note of that verse 6. We'll come back to it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Psalm 64, verse 1.
Psalm 61,
this was
verset
King
1.
David praying.
Ça, c'était la prière du roi David.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. You see, oh God, is this NLT? Yes. It says, oh God, listen to my complaint. Amen. The King Amen. James Version say, yeah, my prayer, O Lord. Amen. So the complaint here is not used in a negative light.
Dans, oh Dieu, écoute ma voix. Quand, oui, dans le, écoute ma voix ou ma plainte, c'est pas une phrase négative.
Mm-hmm. It says, hear my voice, O God, in my prayer. Preserve my life from fear of the enemy. I pray every fear. Go ahead, sorry.
Dans, écoute ma prière et protège ma vie contre l'ennemi que je crains.
So I pray any area of your life where the enemy has put fear, let it be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Donc je prie que tout aspect dans votre vie où l'ennemi a mis la peur, que ce soit détruit au nom de Jésus Christ.
I encourage us to read Psalm 64 and go down at a certain point. Let me open in my Bible and I'll be able
Donc,
to give you the verse.
Il Psalm vous encourage 64. À lire le psaume 64 jusqu'à la fin parce que dans un certain point.
There was a, there's simply a verse in verse. Wait. Okay. I don't have it here, but simply the verse is pointing out that the Lord will send an arrow to the enemy. Hallelujah. A lot of times we have the tendencies that unfortunately I don't have the verse. I'll find it and give it to you shortly. But the enemy, we have the tendency of praying Psalms 91, saying, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow by day.
Donc,
no, that's verse 1. It's okay. It's there? Thank you. It says, woo wet. This is King James. Go to NLT to simplify it for them. It's King James. It's NLT? Hallelujah. It says, they sharpen their tongues like swords and aim their bitter words like arrows. Amen?
Amen.
They shoot from ambush at the innocent, attacking suddenly and fearlessly. Next. They encourage each other to do evil and plan how to set their traps in secret. Who will ever notice? They ask. Next.
Six.
As they plot their crimes, they say, we have devise the perfect plan. Yes, the human heart and mind are cunning. So the enemy looks at our hearts sometimes when he attacks us. Next.
Donc, l'ennemi regarde nos cœurs quand il nous attaque parfois.
Verse 7. But God himself will shoot them with his arrows, suddenly striking them down. Amen.
Amen.
So I've come to tell you that every arrow that has been sent to you returns back to sender in Jesus' name.
Je suis venu vous dire que toute flèche qui a été lancée contre vous retourne à l'expéditeur au nom de Jésus-Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
So coming back to you were on Nehemiah 1 verse 6. Simply, Nehemiah
Donc,
had a burden.
Nous retournons à Néhémie, chapitre 6, verset 1-6. Oui,
yes.
Juste pour nous dire que Néhémie avait un fardeau.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
1 verse 6, right? We've already read. Go to the next verse.
Verset 7.
Go back. It's Nehemiah was praying here. He says, we have sinned terribly by not obeying the commands, decrees, and regulations that you gave us through your servant Moses. Next.
Verse 8.
Please remember what you told your servant Moses. If Amen. You are unfaithful to me, I will scatter you among the nations. I pray you won't be unfaithful in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Amen.
Mais vous ne serez pas fidèles au nom puissant de Jésus-Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
We are in a Bible-believing church.
Nous sommes dans une église qui croit aux Écritures.
The apostle teaches us revelational words constantly.
Et l'apôtre nous donne des enseignements sur la révélation de la parole de Dieu constamment.
When you disobey,
quand vous désobéissez,
you're allowing the enemy to play around with you.
Vous permettez à l'ennemi de s'amuser avec vous.
Apostle simply instructed, come on Wednesdays, we're doing some prophetic prayers.
L'apôtre a juste donné des instructions, venez les mercredis, nous faisons des prières prophétiques.
Let us walk in that level of obedience.
Marchons dans ce niveau.
I pray that will be somebody's portion in this room in
Je
Jesus'
que
name.
Ce soit la portion de
Amen.
Au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.
So he continued on, next verse.
Verset
9. That's 9. It's go back. That's a continuation of 9. It says, I will bring, next, you back to the place I have chosen for my name to be honored. Did I read the one before? Let me see. Okay, good. So now, you need to understand this. A lot of times, go to 7, yes.
Dans ce que vous devez comprendre, on va retourner au verset 7, que la majeure partie...
He said, we have sinned terribly by not obeying. Amen.
Nous avons terriblement péché en désobéissant.
When you disobey the Lord, it can push you into error.
Quand vous désobéissez au Seigneur, ça peut vous mener à l'erreur.
Amen. But that shall not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Psalms 51,
la Bible nous dit dans le Psalm 51
that a repentant heart he will not refuse.
Un cœur repenti, il ne va pas.
So what I loved about Nehemiah here is that he did not only repent for himself, he repented for his forefathers, his ancestors, his parents.
Qu'on aime avec Néhémie ici, c'est qu'il ne s'est pas juste repenti pour lui, mais il s'est repenti pour ses ancêtres.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
So when we are in that mode of repentance, let us repent. Whether there are sins that we did knowingly.
Donc, quand nous sommes dans ce mode de repentance, nous devons nous repentir, que ce soit des péchés que nous avons commis consciemment ou inconsciemment.
Yes, and even the sins that people from the lineage of our family might have sinned.
Et même les péchés des personnes de nos ancêtres.
Amen.
Amen.
Because one of the things Nehemiah was emphasizing is being unfaithful.
Et une des choses dont Néhémie mettait l'emphase sur, c'était l'infidélité.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. So if we are faithful unto God, we will experience blessings. That shall be your portion in Jesus' name.
Si nous sommes fidèles envers Dieu, nous allons expérimenter la bénédiction et c'est notre partage au nom de Jésus. Mm-hmm. Amen.
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 Let's go back to 9.
On retourne au verset 9.
Alléluia. It says, but if you return to me and obey my commands and live by them, then even if you are exiled to the ends of the earth, I will bring, go next, you back to the place I have chosen for my name to be honored. 10. The people you rescued by your great power and strong hand are your servants. Next. Oh Lord, please hear my prayer and listen to the prayers of those who delight in honoring you. Amen. Grant me success today by making the king favorable to me. Amen. I pray that shall be somebody's portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. He did not come unto God and just started asking for a request. He repented.
Il n'est pas venu à Dieu et juste commencé à demander sa requête. Il s'est d'abord repenti.
He repented and reminded him of who he was. That's Nehemiah.
Il s'est repenti et il a rappelé de qui il était lui.
Because he was faithful unto God.
Parce qu'il était fidèle envers Dieu.
Amen. Amen. When you go before God, you should have the confidence of who you are to him.
Quand vous allez devant Dieu, vous devez avoir confiance de qui vous êtes en lui.
Should we repent? Yes, we should, but know who you are in Christ.
Est-ce qu'on doit se repentir? Oui, nous devons nous repentir, mais nous devons être conscients de notre identité en Christ.
And notice, he said that the king, go back to the same verse 11. Yes, he says, please grant me success today by making... Yes, the king favorable to me put it into his heart to be kind to me. I pray that will be somebody's portion in Jesus' name.
Je prie que ça Amen. Sera la portion de quelqu'un au nom de Jésus. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
So later on, Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 5, you can go to 5.
Bon, on va dans Nehemiah chapter 2, verset 5.
Nehemiah was a cupbearer, as we all know.
Nehemiah était les chansons, comme nous le savons.
And when he came before the king,
et quand il s'est présenté devant le roi,
the king noticed that he wasn't unhappy.
Le roi a remarqué qu'il était attristé.
Amen. Amen. He was that close to the king.
Il était si proche au roi.
Mm-hmm. Amen. It says, after the king had asked him what the issue was, and then he replied and told him about the broken walls.
Après que le roi l'ait questionné et qu'il ait répliqué, lui parlant des murailles qui étaient en ruine.
Yes. And the king was asking him more about prayer. If they can do some kind of prayer.
Et le roi lui demandait s'il pouvait élever des prières.
And he said, I replied, if it pleases the king and if you are pleased with me, I pray somebody will be pleased to you, with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I bon, pray
si
that...
Ça, yes. Si ça plaît au roi, et je prie que quelqu'un soit content de vous au nom de Jésus.
Amen. Amen. That whosoever you walk under shall be favorable to you in Jesus'
que
name.
Que ce soit dont vous travaillez en dessous soit vous soit favorable au nom de Jésus.
It says, Amen. If it pleases the king, if you are pleased with me, your servant, send me to Judah to rebuild the city where my ancestors, next.
Verset 5.
Are buried. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go on to the next. It says, the king with the queen sitting beside him asked, how long will you be gone? I pray somebody will value you that much in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Non, je prie que quelqu'un vous montre tant de valeur au nom de Jésus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Because not only was he favorable to the king.
Non, il n'a pas seulement eu la faveur du roi.
But the king was willing to follow. He gave him like an open check to say,
non.
How long are you going to take?
Non, le roi lui a donné comme un chèque ouvert en lui donnant la lassitude de décider du temps que ça lui prendra.
I pray you receive that kind of favor in this month
Je
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
De faveur ce matin au nom
so somebody would favor you beyond your expectations in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Au-delà de vos attentes au nom puissant de Jésus-Christ.
Amen. He continued on.
Et il yes. a continué.
Says how long? I would. Next. He says how long? Go back. He says after I told him how long I would. Begun, the king agreed to my request. I pray the Lord will cause an agreement for your request in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Je prie que le Seigneur accorde votre requête au nom de Jésus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. Next, in still the same Nehemiah 2.
Toujours dans Nehemiah 2.
Nehemiah goes on to start building the defenses. Go on down. After 9, go to 10. Go to the next verse. Thank you. But when Sambalat the Horonite and Tobiah the Ammonite official heard of my arrival, they were very displeased that someone had come. Next, to help the people of Israel. Amen.
Amen.
And so it says, so I arrived in Jerusalem 3 days later. Next. I slept out during the night, taking only a few orders with me. Somebody say discretion. Somebody say discretion. Amen.
Discretion.
Yes. Amen. So what did he do when he went to start building the walls?
Donc qu'est-ce qu'il a fait quand il a commencé à bâtir les murailles?
He was discreet.
Il était discret.
I slipped out during the night, taking only a few orders with me. I pray you should be one of the few chosen in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Je prie que vous soyez parmi les peu les choisis au nom de Jésus.
It says I had not told anyone about the plans God had put in my heart. Amen.
Amen.
That's still in the line of discretion. Hallelujah.
C'est toujours dans la discrétion.
Sometimes you need to pray out something.
Parfois, vous devez d'abord prier pour quelque chose.
To bring it into life.
Avant de réaliser cela.
I heard a man of God who said a lot of times we're quick to receive the prophetic word.
Et il a entendu un homme de Dieu qui dit que parfois on s'empresse de recevoir une parole prophétique.
But sometimes to give birth to what has been prophesied or God has revealed to you.
Mais parfois pour comme accoucher ou aboutir que cette prophétie là puisse aboutir.
Spend that time in prayer to solidify its foundation. Amen.
Passer le temps dans la prière pour comme renforcer, solidifier la fondation.
Because if we don't have a strong, think of any house. If it doesn't have a strong foundation, it can easily be swept away.
Donc pensez même quand on bâtit une maison, si la fondation n'est pas solide, ça peut être emporté.
At the beginning of a revelation, it's not time for you to go and speak to everybody and let them know.
Donc au début d'une révélation, c'est pas le moment d'aller parler aux gens pour les faire connaître cela.
We need to be discreet like Nehemiah.
Nous devons être discrets comme Néhémie.
Can we go to 16?
Merci 16.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. He says, the city officials did not know I had been out there or what I was doing, for I had not yet said anything to anyone about my plans. I had not, next, yet spoken to the Jewish leaders, the priests, the nobles, the officials, or anyone else in the administration. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So a lot of times we need to have wisdom about timing.
La majeure partie du temps, nous devons avoir la sagesse pour le timing.
He was conscious that it was not the time to activate.
Il était conscient que c'était pas le moment de faire connaître les choses.
But one of the things I saw that in him going out and watching how the state of Jerusalem.
Donc, une des choses qu'il a vu, c'est que quand il sortait pour
surveiller,
quand il faisait une évaluation des murs de Jérusalem.
So, simply, he was surveying to know how he was going to strategize.
Donc, il était juste en train de faire une évaluation pour voir comment est-ce qu'il va faire sa stratégie.
Can we go to Nehemiah 4, verse 1?
On va aller dans Néhémie 4, verset 1.
Alléluia. Amen.
Amen.
4 verse 1. It says, Sambalat was very angry when he learned that we were rebuilding the wall. He flew into a rage and mocked the Jews. I pray that anybody that mocks you shall be disgraced in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Ma prière est que quiconque ce soit qui se moque de vous soit souillé au nom de Jésus-Christ. Amen.
Amen. Continue on, next verse. It says, saying in front of his friends and the Samaritan army officers, what does this bunch of poor, feeble Jews think they're doing? They think they can build a wall in a single day by just offering a few sacrifices. Do they actually think they can make something of stones from a rubbish heap and charred ones at that? Amen?
Amen.
I remember when my wife and I were about to buy our house.
Je me souviens quand mon épouse et moi, on était sur le point d'acheter notre maison.
And she shared the vision to someone who was really, really negative about it. Like, it's going to take you to a lot of depths. It's going to be very difficult.
Et elle a partagé la vision avec quelqu'un qui était vraiment négatif par rapport à cela. Et la personne lui disait, oh non, vous allez contracter beaucoup de dettes, ça va être très difficile.
We did not give in to it.
Et nous n'avons pas succombé à cela.
We followed what our plan was.
Nous avons suivi nos plans.
And today, since the 2020 until now, we've been with 2024, about 4 years, 4 to 5 years now in the house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is to say what? Are people going to mock what your dreams are?
Et qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Est-ce que les gens vont se moquer de vos rêves?
Are people going to have negative words towards your dreams?
Est-ce que les gens vont avoir des paroles négatives par rapport à vos
know
rêves?
Know the vision the Lord has given you.
Connaissez la vision que le Seigneur vous a donnée.
Stick by it.
Tenez-vous.
And that is why you start by prayer and fasting.
C'est pour ça que vous commencez avec la prière et le jeûne.
Because even Jesus said it, this kind cometh not out but by fasting and prayers.
Parce que même Jésus a dit que ce genre de démons pour les chasser que par la prière et le jeûne.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Amen. So let's go to verse 7.
Donc nous allons au verset 7.
He says, but when Sambalat and Tobiah and Arabs, Ammonites and Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead and that the gaps in the wall of Jerusalem were being repaired, they were furious. I pray somebody will be furious because they see your success in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In this month of blessing, they shall be furious because God has blessed you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. La prière, c'est que des gens soient furieux parce que ils voient la bénédiction de Dieu dans votre vie. En ce mois de bénédiction, ils vont s'enrager à cause de la bénédiction de Dieu dans votre vie. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Go on to verse 9. Yes. He says, they all made plans to come and fight against the Jerusalem and throw us into confusion. But we prayed to our God and guarded the city day and night to protect ourselves. I pray that will be your portion in the spiritual realm in Jesus' name.
Que ce soit votre partage de prier jour et nuit pour que le Seigneur vous protège au nom de Jésus. Amen.
Amen. Can we go to 16 and 17?
Verses
16 and 17. Hallelujah. It says, but from then on, only half my men worked, while the other half stood guard with spears, shields, bows, and coats of mail. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you read further down, you see that they were saying at one point some of them were holding their tools to work with, and the other hand was holding a tool to fight. Amen.
Quand on continue la lecture, on se rend compte qu'à un certain niveau, il tenait une main pour combattre et l'autre main pour bâtir.
In other words, it's to tell you that when God gives you an opportunity, it's not time to relax.
C'est pour vous dire quoi que quand Dieu vous donne une opportunité, c'est pas le moment de vous relaxer.
You still listen to him.
Vous l'écoutez toujours.
And stay steadfast in prayer.
Et vous demeurez dans la prière.
And fasting.
Et le jeûne.
Go on to 17.
Merci.
Or maybe 16 is not done yet. 16 was not done, right? It was done? Good. Go back to, yes. It says, the leaders, yes, next, stationed themselves behind the people of Judah, 17, who were building the wall. The laborers carried on their work with one hand supporting the load and one hand holding a weapon. Amen.
Amen.
I pray you'll be ever ready like that in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Toujours prêt comme cela au nom puissant de Jésus-Christ. Amen.
Amen. Now, go on to the next verse, 18. All the builders had a sword belted to their side. The trumpeter stayed with me to sound the alarm. Next. Then I explained to the nobles and officials and all the people, the work is very spread out and we are widely separated from each other. Amen?
Amen.
Next. Along the wall. When you hear the blast of the trumpet, rush to wherever it is sounding. Then our God will fight for us. I pray our God will fight for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Why did I want us to see that verse 20? It's simply to see that you need direction.
Vous avez besoin de la direction.
Amen. Amen. There was a specific instruction he was doing that you be more secured when you hear the trumpet because Jerusalem was very vast.
Non, c'était pour que vous soyez plus sécurisés quand vous écoutez la trompette parce que Jérusalem était très vaste.
They had to run to the place that would be more solidified in, can I say, protection.
Courir dans un endroit qui était plus approprié pour la protection.
When you come and you speak to the apostle,
quand vous venez parler à l'apôtre,
when you come and you speak to any of the pastors,
ou vous parlez à n'importe quel des pasteurs,
do not underestimate where you, what the directives and the instructions that are given to you.
Ne sous-estimez pas les directives et les instructions qu'on va vous donner.
They're for a purpose.
C'est là pour un but.
Amen. You Amen. Want to see results? There's an act you have to do.
Vous voulez avoir des résultats, il y a des actions que vous devez mener.
Amen. Amen. How can you expect to be blessed regularly if you're inconsistent with your tithing?
Comment est-ce que vous attendez à être béni de manière régulière quand vous n'êtes pas constant avec votre dîme?
Amen.
Amen.
We're not going to go there, right? Amen. So simply, you have to be obedient.
Donc tout simplement, vous devez être obéissant.
Hallelujah. Nehemiah was governor for over 12 years. Over 12, yes.
Oui, Nehemiah était gouverneur pendant plus de 12 ans.
So that is to emphasize that for a long time, he had to continue with this project.
Ça veut dire quoi? C'est que pendant une très longue période, il devait continuer avec ce projet.
Nehemiah 6, verse 10.
Nehemiah 6, verset 10.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says 10, you gave me 14. It says, later I went to visit Shemaiah, son of Delaiah, and grandson of Mehetabel, who was confined to his home. He said, let us meet together. Next. Inside the temple of God and bolt the doors shut. Your enemies are coming to kill you tonight. Next. But I replied, should someone in my position run from danger? Should someone in my position enter the temple to save his life? No. Won't do it. Next. I realized that God had not spoken to him, but that he had uttered his prophecy against me because Tobiah and Sambalat had hired him. I pray every secret plot against your life be revealed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Que tout plan secret dans votre vie soit révélé au nom puissant de Jésus-Christ.
My focus there is not the prophecy.
Dans le focus là, c'est pas la prophétie.
My focus there is that the enemy always has a secret plot.
Le focus là, c'est quoi? C'est que l'ennemi a toujours un plan secret.
Sometimes you can have dreams that will make you walk in fear.
Parfois, vous pouvez avoir des rêves qui vont vous faire avoir peur.
Circumstances that surround you and you're worried.
Des circonstances qui vous entourent et vous êtes
But inquiet. As children of God, we need to be bold like Nehemiah.
En tant qu'enfant de Dieu, nous devons être aussi braves que Nehemiah.
Because he did not listen to what the enemy had planned through Tobiah and Sambalat.
Parce qu'il n'a pas succombé à ce que l'ennemi avait planifié par Sambalat et Tobiah.
Mm-hmm. That's why he was able to achieve what God had sent him for.
C'est Amen? Pour ça qu'il était capable d'accomplir ce que Dieu l'a envoyé faire.
Mm-hmm. When we look at the life of Samson,
quand nous observons la vie de Samson,
we understand that this was a man anointed by God.
Nous comprenons que c'était un homme oint de Dieu.
Mm-hmm. We can see this in Judges 15 to 20.
Nous
I don't have a lot of time.
Pouvons voir cela dans Judges 6, 20.
But because he lived a life of alcohol, living with women that we know Delilah was a foreign woman.
Parce qu'il menait une vie pas saine, l'alcool, les femmes. Et nous savons que Dalila était une femme étrangère.
It cost him his downfall.
Ça lui a coûté sa chute.
Even though at the end he was restored.
Même quand à la fin il était restauré.
But his ministry was cut short.
Mais son ministère a été accompli.
Amen.
Amen.
When God gives us instructions and we disobey them.
Quand Dieu nous donne les instructions et nous les désobéissons.
It could even cost us our lives.
Ça peut même nous coûter nos vies.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To conclude, can we go to 2 Timothy?
Pour conclure, nous allons aller dans 2 Timothée.
Chapter 3.
Chapitre 3.
Let's go there. 3 verse 10, sorry.
3:10.
Yeah, I didn't give you the verse. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, but you, Timothy, certainly know what I teach and how I live and what my purpose in life is. You know my faith, my patience. These are things that we all believers have to work on. My faith, my patience, my love, because these will preserve you. And endurance, next. You know how much persecution. So despite the challenges, he still held. Let's go back to that previous verse.
Non, malgré les défis,
he still held on to his faith. He still held on to his patience.
À sa foi, sa patience.
The love of God.
Son amour pour Dieu
and his love for his fellow brethren
et son amour
kept
pour
on.
Ses bien-aimés,
il and continue. Next, my endurance.
Et son
hallelujah.
Amen.
I pray that the Lord will give you endurance in this season in the mighty name
et
of Jesus
que
Christ.
Le Seigneur donne l'endurance
amen.
Son nom puissant
can,
de
we
Jésus
go to, can we go to chapter 4? Verse 7.
Nous sommes toujours dans 2 Timothée, chapitre 4, verset 7.
Hallelujah. We as believers have to build endurance no matter what we face. It says, I have fought the good fight. I have finished and the race and I have remained faithful. I pray you shall remain faithful in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Donc il dit, j'ai combattu le bon combat, j'ai achevé la course et j'ai gardé la foi. Je prie que vous gardez la foi au nom puissant de Jésus-Christ. Amen.
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 Why did I title this message the bigger picture?
Pourquoi est-ce qu'il a intitulé le message une plus grande vue?
When I see, think of Nehemiah, I think of someone walking via a road.
Donc, quand il voit Nehemiah, il voit quelqu'un qui va au travers d'un chemin.
Blocks falling.
Des morceaux de je sais pas de blocs qui tombent.
Heavy stones, if you may call it.
Ou des pierres qui tombent.
Which are what? Obstacles.
Qui sont quoi des obstacles?
Challenges.
Des défis.
But you press on.
Mais vous continuez.
You continue on.
Vous avancez.
And you can we go back to that verse I gave in 2 Timothy 3?
2 Timothée 3.
Amen.
Amen.
Verse 10. Verset 10. Yes, he says you continue on.
Vous continuez.
You need to be strengthening your faith.
Vous devez être fortifié.
Your faith
dans
should
votre
be
foi.
Tangible.
Votre foi
why? Because you know the God you serve.
Parce que vous connaissez le Dieu que vous servez.
It might seem like everyone is having the blessing and I'm not seeing mine.
C'est comme si les gens ça paraît comme si les gens ont les bénédictions et moi j'ai pas de bénédictions.
But because I have faith in my God.
Mais parce que j'ai la foi en mon Dieu.
What happens? I continue on.
Je continue.
It might take time.
Ça peut prendre du temps.
It might be next door.
Ça peut être
but
à
I
la
have
prochaine
to continue on.
Mais je dois continuer.
I have to be patient.
Je dois être patient.
Because it's the fruit of the Spirit.
Parce que c'est
Galatians
5:22. Galates 5:22.
If say you are one with the Spirit,
vous êtes un avec l'esprit.
God is a God of love.
Dieu est un Dieu
so
d'amour.
That should be automatically in our lives.
Donc Dieu doit automatiquement
God is a God whose Spirit is in us.
Dieu qui a son esprit en nous.
We are one with Him.
Nous
he is one with us.
Et il est un
so
avec
we
nous.
Should. Be patient.
Nous
amen.
Amen.
And all this will build us to what?
Et tout ceci va nous mener à quoi?
Next verse. Just you don't have to go to the next verse. The next line. To endurance.
À
I pray that shall be your portion in the
je
mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Christ.
Can we rise at this moment? Take note before we conclude.
Avant de conclure, notez ceci.
Nehemiah did something when he came
chose
to build.
Quand il est venu bâtir.
Amen.
Amen.
Nehemiah 2, verse 18. Nehemiah
2, 18.
Can you give me that? Nehemiah 2, verse 18.
Nehemiah 2, 18.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is somebody being blessed? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. Are you there? Thank you. It says, then I told them about how the gracious hand of God had been on me and about my conversation with the king. I pray you will testify of what God has done in your life in Jesus' name.
Ma prière, c'est que vous allez témoigner de ce que Dieu a fait dans votre vie au nom puissant
de
Jésus-Christ.
He testified.
Il a témoigné.
Nehemiah had to testify and he brought results.
Témoigner et il a eu les résultats.
Amen. That's why you don't sit back in the back of the room and think, I'm too shy to give a testimony.
C'est pour ça que vous ne vous asseyez pas derrière la salle et vous dites non, j'ai trop honte pour donner mon témoignage.
When I tell people, I know I've also said it quite a few times. When I tell people that I'm an introvert, people don't believe me.
Because
I'm very out there, right?
Parce que lui aussi il est introverti parce qu'il est trop.
But guess what? From the age of 9-10, I always got pushed to do things.
De l'âge de 9-10 ans, il se retrouvait toujours en avant pour
when
faire
you
des
are
choses.
The personality where you're jovial with everybody,
quand vous avez une personnalité joyeuse envers
even
tout le
monde, you, you know you're shy,
même si vous êtes conscient du fait que vous avez honte,
and you're pushed and you seize on the opportunity, what happens? You will do greater
et
things.
Et vous êtes propulsé et vous saisissez les opportunités.
Amen.
Qu'est-ce qui va se passer? Vous
is
allez
anybody
faire des
believing
choses?
They're going to testify in the mighty name of Jesus Christ?
Amen.
The word of God says in Revelations 12:11.
La parole de Dieu nous dit dans Apocalypse 12:11.
We overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony.
Le sang de l'agneau et les paroles de nos témoignages.
So this is our prayer point.
Donc voici notre point de prière.
Lord, give me a testimony like you did for Nehemiah in
Seigneur,
the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Donne-moi un témoignage lift tel que your... tu as donné à Néhémie au
Let's
nom de Jésus-Christ.
Let's pray Jesus' mighty name.
Prions
excellent God, we give you all the glory. Excellent God, we praise your name. Excellent God, you are worthy. Hallelujah, King of Kings. Hallelujah, you are worthy. Hallelujah, you are awesome. Be thou magnified. Be thou magnified. We worship and we give you all the glory. Strengthen us, oh King of Kings, that we will have a testimony like you did for Abraham, like you did for Nehemiah. Father, fulfill your divine purpose and your will. In Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. We read 2 Timothy 3. Can you go back to that? 10, 11.
2 Timothée 3, verset 10.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
When we look at the bigger picture,
quand nous avons une plus grande image,
obstacles,
nous voyons plus loin, les obstacles,
obstacles become minute to
les
us.
Obstacles deviennent minimes pour nous.
You brush your shoulders and you move on.
Vous
amen.
Tapez les épaules et vous avancez.
It says, no, not Revelation 12. That's not what I said. 2 Timothy 3, verse 10. Hallelujah. You did it. Yes. So, say, oh Lord.
Oh Seigneur.
Go to 11, let me see. Mm-hmm. What version are you giving me? It's very different from what you gave earlier. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you. Yes. It says, you know my faith, my patience, and my love, and my endurance. Amen. I pray that will be somebody's portion in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
So he's saying, oh Lord.
Oh Seigneur.
My faith,
ma foi,
my patience,
ma patience,
my love,
mon amour,
and my endurance,
et mon endurance
will help me see the bigger picture.
Me permettront
lift up your voice and pray in Jesus' mighty
et
name. Excellent God, we give you all the glory. Excellent God, we worship you. Lord, strengthen us in this season of blessings that we will see the bigger picture. Lord, that we will not, be derailed in any way, shape, or form. Hallelujah, the King of Kings. Hallelujah, the Lord of Lords. The mighty man in battle. Fulfill your divine purpose and your will. Oh, Coco Shatamalaka City. Hallelujah, King of Kings. Oh, you shall do it for us. Be build us in faith, build us in patience, build us in love and in endurance. Fulfill your divine purpose and your will. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. One last prayer point before we go.
Un dernier sujet de prière avant de partir.
Amen.
Amen.
Say, oh Lord.
Oh Seigneur.
Every Sambalat.
Tout Sambalat.
Every Tobiah.
Tout Tobiah.
That tries to intimidate.
Qui choisit d'intimider.
Or mock my vision.
Ou de se moquer de ma vision.
Scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Au nom
lift
de
up your voices
Christ.
And pray. Father, we worship
prier.
And we give you
Seigneur,
all the glory. Every Tobiah. Every Sambalat. Intimidating. Oh, my vision. In ministry.
Tout
in my calling.
Seigneur,
in my family. In my marriage.
Faire,
in every project I do. Let them be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let them be scattered. By the power in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you have done it. Holy Spirit, you are fulfilling your will. We adore and we praise your name. You are awesome. You are glorious. Be thou magnified. Be thou glorified in our midst. We worship you, King of Kings. You are fulfilling your will, Jehovah. You are fulfilling your divine purpose and your will. Lord, we are seeing the bigger picture and nothing else. Have your way, Lord. In Jesus. Jesus, mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
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 Come on, celebrate him, celebrate him. Thank you, Jesus.
Merci, Jésus.
Come on, keep celebrating the Lord.
Célébrons le Seigneur.
Keep celebrating the Lord. Thank
Célébrons
you, Holy Ghost.
Célébrons le Seigneur. Merci, Saint-Esprit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Merci,
thank
Jésus.
Thank you, Holy Ghost. In
merci,
the name
Saint-Esprit.
Of Jesus.
Au
just
nom de Jésus.
Just stretch your hands and pray for God's servant.
Étendez vos mains et priez pour le serviteur
and ask the Lord
de Dieu.
To replenish the virtue.
Et demandez au Seigneur de remplacer la vertu.
Can I hear you pray? Can I have
est-ce qu'on peut vous entendre prier?
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
merci,
you, Holy
Jésus.
Spirit.
Merci, Saint-Esprit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Seigneur, nous te disons
thank
merci
you, Holy
pour
Spirit.
Tout ce que tu as fait.
La
merci,
in Jesus' name we pray. Come on, people, celebrate the Lord. Thank you for that word. Thank you for that word. Amen.
Merci pour cette
Alleluia.
Parole. Alleluia.
You see that Nehemiah did not give up.
Nous voyons que Néhémie n'a pas abandonné.
He was persistent.
Il était persistant.
And we have heard today.
Et nous avons suivi
he
aujourd'hui.
He was confident about his identity.
Il était confiant de son identité.
The depth of your confidence of who you are will guarantee the success of what you are doing.
La profondeur de la de votre compréhension de qui vous êtes va garantir votre succès
when
au nom de
Jésus. When you begin
to
doubt who you are. Hmm.
Quand vous commencez à douter de votre
because
identité,
one thing which I can tell you,
parce qu'une chose que je peux vous dire,
you will always have the Sambala and the Tobiah.
Vous aurez toujours les Sambala et les Tobiah.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
And whether you like it or not,
et que vous l'aimez ou pas,
in the French service, Pastor Jonah was talking about the meaning of the name Sambala and Tobiah.
Dans le service en français, le pasteur Jonah nous a parlé de la signification des noms Sambala et Tobiah.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
Listen to me.
Écoutez.
They are always going to be there.
Ils seront toujours
whether
là.
Whether they are there physically or spiritually.
Qu'ils soient là spirituellement ou physiquement.
But look at the prayers of Paul.
Mais regardez
look
les
at what Paul
de
said
Paul.
To Timothy.
Regardez ce que Paul a dit à
he
Timothée.
He said, you know my faith.
Dit, tu connais ma
you
foi.
You know how I live.
Tu connais comment je vis.
You know my patience.
Tu connais ma patience.
You know my love.
Tu connais mon
you
amour.
Know my endurance.
Et tu connais mon
in
endurance.
The midst of all the persecution.
Au sein de toute cette persécution.
My faith was still there.
Ma foi demeure
my love
toujours.
Was still there.
Mon amour
my endurance
toujours.
Was still there.
Mon endurance demeure toujours.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
Because one thing which is certain.
Parce qu'une chose qui est
anything
certaine,
which is of God.
Hey, c'est que toute chose qui vient
any
de
destiny
Dieu,
which is of God.
Toute destinée qui vient de Dieu.
There are some people that must answer present.
Il y a certains qui vont répondre présent.
The Sambala must tell you I am here.
Les Sambala vont vous dire je suis là.
And the Tobias must say hey don't forget about me.
Et les Tobias vont dire hey ne m'oubliez pas.
That is not your problem.
C'est pas votre problème.
Stay focused.
Demeurez focus.
Are you there with me?
Amen.
Endurance.
L'endurance,
perseverance.
La persévérance.
And you will accomplish.
Et vous allez accomplir.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
The wall was built.
Les murailles ont été rebâties.
It was built.
Elles ont été
no
rebâties.
Matter what they say.
Peu importe ce qu'ils ont dit.
They will mock at you.
Ils vont se moquer de
they
vous.
Will call you names.
Ils vont vous appeler
look at your neighbor
par des
say,
noms.
I have passed that level.
Dis à ton voisin, j'ai dépassé
where
ce
what
niveau.
People, how, where the mocking of people discourage me, I have passed that level.
La moquerie des gens, non, 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 je ne me soucie plus de ça.
And you are going to speak like David, eh?
Et vous allez parler comme David, eh?
David said.
David a dit.
When they were mocking him.
Quand ils se moquaient de lui.
And one of his soldiers said, "Let me kill that person who is mocking at me."
Et un de ses soldats a dit, "Laisse-moi tuer ces gens-là qui se moquent de toi."
Because God doesn't give you permission to kill your mockers.
Parce que Dieu ne te donne pas l'autorisation de tuer ceux qui se moquent de toi.
There are some mockers who will only stop mocking you when their mocking is no longer affecting you.
Il y a des moqueurs qui vont se taire quand leurs moqueries n'auront plus un effet sur vous.
If you are always crying because they are mocking hey. You, God is saying that you still have something
oh,
to learn.
Oh yeah. Donc si vous pleurez toujours quand on se moque de vous, Dieu est en train de vous dire que vous avez encore beaucoup à apprendre.
Did you see? Hello. Did God kill Sambala?
Est-ce que Dieu a tué Sambala?
Read the Bible.
Non, il faut lire la Bible.
The Bible is there because we are still talking about Nehemiah because it's an overflow from the bootcamp.
Donc, nous parlons toujours de Nehemiah parce que c'est un débordement du bootcamp.
I know this is a month of blessing.
Je sais que ça c'est le mois de bénédiction.
But the Lord said we have to still exhaust Nehemiah first.
Mais le Seigneur a dit que nous devons épuiser Nehemiah.
And then we will go to blessings.
Et là nous allons aller dans la bénédiction.
So even if we start blessings at the end of this month or next week or another month, that's fine.
Donc même si nous commençons la bénédiction à la fin du mois ou la semaine prochaine, c'est correct.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce
the Bible says, Sambala and Tobiah were there.
Sambala et Tobiah étaient
and
là.
And they saw the wall.
Et ils ont vu
that was built.
Les murailles qui étaient bâties.
Nothing will stop you.
Rien ne pourra vous empêcher.
Look at your
Amen.
Neighbor. Say, I am too full of the Holy Ghost to be stopped.
Je suis tellement rempli du Saint-Esprit pour m'arrêter.
I am too full of fire to be stopped.
Je suis tellement rempli de feu.
I am too full of power to be stopped.
Je suis tellement rempli de puissance
pour m'arrêter. Say, nothing can stop me.
Rien ne peut m'arrêter.
Because my God is with me.
Parce que mon Dieu
and whether the devil
moi.
Loves it or not,
et que le diable
I will finish.
Je vais
my mission on earth. Celebrate him if you believe that.
Célébrez-le si vous croyez.
Nothing can stop me.
Rien ne peut m'arrêter.
I will finish.
Je vais achever.
Are you done with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
I told you sometimes, eh?
Je vous ai dit il y a quelque temps.
Mockers energizes me.
Les moqueurs me donnent plus d'énergie.
Aïe, 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 aïe. I say mockers energizes me.
Les moqueurs me donnent plus d'énergie.
Let me tell you a little secret.
Laissez-moi vous donner un petit secret.
Most of the time where my ministry has transitioned to another level.
Dans la majeure partie du temps pour que le ministère de l'apôtre puisse faire une transition d'un niveau à un
autre. When the anointing moves to another level.
Quand l'onction va à une autre dimension.
Many of those times.
La majeure partie
I'm
de cette
tell you what happened.
Je vais vous dire ce qui va se passer.
When people start mocking,
quand les gens commencent à se moquer,
criticize,
critiquer,
and say all kinds of nonsense
et dire toutes sortes de conneries,
then I go back to God.
Et là, ils retournent vers Dieu.
I say, Father,
Père,
give me that power,
donne-moi cette puissance,
that anointing,
cette onction
that will put them to shame.
Qui va les faire mettre à la honte, les faire avoir honte.
I say, Lord, listen,
Seigneur.
The only way to answer mockers is result.
Le seul moyen de répondre à ces moqueurs là, c'est des résultats.
You cannot explain to somebody who has made up their mind they will never love what you are doing.
Donc, vous pouvez pas expliquer à quelqu'un qui a décidé qu'ils ne vont jamais aimer ce que vous faites.
Have you seen that situation where after you explain to the person, then the person still continue to say what they were saying?
Avez-vous vu cette situation où vous expliquez des choses à quelqu'un et il continue sans tête à dire ce qu'il avait à dire?
And you just know you wasted your time.
Et vous vous rendez compte que vous avez perdu votre temps?
May the hand of result be upon your life.
Que la main du résultat soit sur votre
I
vie.
I say you will produce results.
Vous allez produire
in every area of your life.
Dans tous les domaines de
those
votre
who
vie.
Mock you,
ceux qui se sont
those who shame
vous,
you,
ceux qui vous
those
ont
who
souillé,
insult you,
ceux qui vous ont
they
insulté,
will see the result.
Ils verront
look at your
résultats.
Neighbor, say result, result, result.
Dit, résultat, résultat, résultat.
Celebrate the Lord if you believe that.
Célébrez le Seigneur si vous croyez.
Ah!
Ah!
I say, Lord.
Je dis, Seigneur,
let me tell you something here.
Laissez-moi vous dire quelque chose.
I say, Lord.
Seigneur.
Look at what they are saying.
Regarde ce qu'ils sont en train
take
de dire.
Another level.
Amène-moi à une autre dimension.
I need to go in another level.
J'ai besoin d'aller à une autre dimension.
And that is how God takes me to another dimension.
Et c'est comme ça que Dieu m'amène à une autre dimension.
So I come to discover.
Donc j'ai découvert
that sometimes
que parfois
in about 50% of the time the mocking comes.
Dans à peu près 50% du temps quand il y a cette moquerie.
It's when I began to be slumber.
C'est quand j'ai commencé à somnoler.
Yes.
Sombrer.
When I say oh okay, when I don't I just get complacent.
Quand il devient complaisant,
so God used that to stir me up.
Et Dieu utilise cela pour le réveiller.
I say you have to change this narrative.
Donc tu dois changer ce narratif.
You have to change this narrative.
Tu dois changer cette histoire.
That's why the Lord is telling you to look at the bigger picture.
Et c'est pour ça que le Seigneur nous demande de voir plus loin.
Stop worrying about the little things.
Arrêtez de vous soucier des petits détails. Amen.
You worry about John, worry about Mary, worry about Thomas. You
Jean,
even worry
Marie,
about your fridge,
Thomas.
Worry about your cook, your hey. Stove, worry about rice, worry about stew, worry about bread, worry. Yes. Are you there with me?
Est-ce
look at the bigger picture.
Regardez plus loin, plus grand.
All those little things build up that bigger picture.
Tous ces petits détails-là, c'est ça qui bâtit la plus grande figure.
I know there's somebody here.
Je sais qu'il y a quelqu'un ici.
After you have heard this, you will still worry. But we are following you there where you are worried and we are stopping it there.
Après avoir écouté ceci, vous allez toujours vous plaindre. On vous suit là-bas pour vous arrêter.
Father,
vous
I bind every advance worry. Every future worry.
Je lis toute inquiétude de futur.
Believe.
Croyez.
And it is well.
Et tout va bien.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous
come and celebrate Jesus. Look, tell your neighbor, say, I'm looking at the bigger picture.
Dis à ton voisin, je regarde
and
je
nothing
vois
is
plus
stopping
loin,
me.
Et rien ne m'arrête.
No Sambala.
Aucun Sambala.
No Tobaya.
Aucun Tobaya.
What I have started with God, I will finish
Dieu,
it.
Je vais l'achever.
Celebrate him if you believe that.
Célébrez-le si vous croyez.
Yay!
Yay!
Hey. It will be finished.
Ça sera
by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Par la puissance du
it will be finished.
Ça sera
I
accompli.
Said it will be finished.
Ça sera accompli.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Merci, Jésus.
Lift up your hand, we're praying.
Levez les mains, nous allons prier.
We are still in the covenant of provision, the covenant time of provision.
Nous sommes toujours selon le temps d'alliance pour la provision.
I don't know, we are hearing testimonies.
Nous entendons, écoutons les témoignages.
God providing people.
Dieu qui a pourvu pour des gens.
We had some in the French service also.
Nous avons suivi certains dans le premier service.
Debt cancellation,
annulation des
money
dettes.
To, God provided money to pay off all the debts.
Et Dieu a pourvu pour que quelqu'un puisse payer toutes ses dettes.
In fact, we had two testimonies like that in the
French
service. Nous
avons eu deux témoignages comme cela dans le service en français.
And there are some who just testified to me quietly in my office.
Et certains donnent le témoignage tranquillement dans le bureau.
What am I saying?
Qu'est-ce que
God is in the business of provision.
Dieu est là pour pouvoir.
That's why in Bible studies we're talking about five ways God provides for us.
C'est pour ça que dans l'étude biblique, on parlait de cinq moyens par lesquels Dieu pourvoit pour nous.
Please follow Bible studies.
S'il vous plaît, suivez l'étude biblique.
You cannot be here and you don't follow Bible studies.
Vous pouvez pas être là et vous ne suivez pas l'étude biblique.
If you don't come physically, follow it online.
Si vous ne venez pas physiquement, vous pouvez suivre en ligne.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous
maybe God is taking me to the place that I'm only going to be preaching in Bible studies.
Peut-être le Seigneur l'amène à cette place où il va juste prêcher durant l'étude biblique.
Oh yes. Hello.
Hello.
But the preaching Bible studies and the school of ministry.
d'en prêcher durant l'étude biblique et l'école du ministère.
I'm not saying I'm there before you stop coming to church on Sunday. I'm saying, I said maybe.
Non, j'ai pas dit que je suis juste là, mais pour que vous ne venez plus à l'église le dimanche, j'ai dit peut-être.
The point is that I want you to also be part of Bible studies.
Non, le point c'est quoi? C'est que vous devez aussi faire partie de l'étude biblique.
But we have had a very good message today.
Mais nous avons eu un très beau message aujourd'hui.
Pastor Johnson.
Du pasteur Johnson.
You have to see the bigger picture.
Vous devez voir plus loin,
you have to
plus
persist
grand.
For the bigger picture.
Vous devez voir cela, apercevoir cela.
And believe that you will succeed.
Et être convaincu que vous allez réussir.
And know your identity.
Et connaissez votre identité.
Amen.
Amen.
So there are five. As we round up, those five things I want to prophesy on your life.
Dans ces cinq choses-là qu'il veut prophétiser dans votre vie.
We said in the Bible study the first way God provides.
L'avons dit durant l'étude biblique la première manière dont Dieu pourvoit.
It gives you the power to create wealth.
Il vous donne la puissance pour créer
wisdom
la richesse.
To create wealth.
La sagesse.
I prophesy it upon your life.
Amen.
Receive that wisdom.
Recevez cette sagesse.
Receive that wisdom.
Recevez cette
receive
sagesse.
That wisdom.
Recevez
wisdom
cette sagesse.
For provisions.
La sagesse
receive
la
it in the name of
au
Jesus.
Nom de Jésus.
Amen. Say amen. I receive it.
Je la reçois.
The second way he provides,
la deuxième manière qu'il pourvoit,
he blesses your seed.
Il bénit votre semence.
In other words, your generosity he blesses.
Non, en d'autres termes, il bénit votre générosité.
Your giving he blesses.
Vos dons il bénit.
Your giving includes your tithe, your seed,
non,
your
vos
offering.
Dons, c'est quoi dire?
He blesses
votre semence.
I prophesy to you. May every of your seed be blessed. Every giving you have given, let it be blessed. That God would touch it for provision.
Que Dieu touchera cela
in
pour
the
la
name
provision.
Of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.
Now those who are not tithing, they are not answering amen to this one.
Ceux qui ne donnent pas leur dîme ne répondent pas amen.
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 Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
May God give you seed to sow.
Que Dieu vous donne la semence pour semer.
So that he will bless that seed.
Pour qu'il puisse bénir cette
semence. I didn't
semence.
Hear your amen to that.
Amen.
Number three, prophetic declaration.
Troisième déclaration prophétique.
I told you the boot camp. The Lord said he has given me a prophetic mantle.
Durant le camp de délivrance, je vous ai dit que le Seigneur a dit qu'il a donné un manteau prophétique.
I already had that, but he has given me a special one for create, to create.
Donc, il avait déjà ce manteau prophétique, mais le Seigneur lui a donné un spécial pour la création.
To speak things and prophetically they are created.
Donc, pour déclarer des choses et de manière prophétique, elles sont créées.
So and we are seeing the testimonies.
Et nous voyons les témoignages.
So you better take this thing serious.
Donc, prenez ces déclaration là au sérieux.
And your amen should not be nodding your head, it should be your mouth. Amen.
Et votre amen ne doit pas être hocher la tête, mais plutôt la déclaration.
If you can stand on your feet when they are doing prophetic declaration.
Si vous pouvez vous tenir debout, tenez-vous debout.
Number three.
Troisième déclaration.
Provision.
La provision.
God creates opportunities.
Dieu crée des opportunités.
I prophesy to you. There will be opportunities.
Qu'il y aura des opportunités.
And you will maximize those opportunities.
Et vous allez maximiser
golden
ces opportunities.
Opportunities.
Des opportunités
opportunities
en or.
Of doors open.
Des opportunités de portes ouvertes.
In Jesus' name.
Au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.
Number four way God provides.
Quatrième manière dont Dieu pourvoit.
Are you there with me?
Est-ce que vous suivez?
He blesses the works of your hands.
Il bénit l'ouvrage de vos mains.
It means that you will not labor and not see the fruit of
ça
your
veut dire quoi que vous n'allez pas travailler sans voir les fruits.
I command the works of your hand to be blessed.
Non, je commande la bénédiction de
l'ouvrage
de votre
main. Whether it's your career, whatever your hand is doing, that is honest and is for your living, I command it to multiply. In the name of Jesus, your hand will not make you to be sorrowful.
Vos mains ne vont pas vous attrister.
Receive it.
Recevez
somebody
cela.
Say, receive it.
Que quelqu'un dise, je
in
reçois.
Jesus' name.
Au nom de
and
Jésus.
Number five way the Lord provides.
Et le cinquième point où le Seigneur
supernatural, miraculous provision.
C'est la provision surnaturelle, miraculeuse.
Where you have toiled in the river.
Où vous avez fouillé dans la rivière.
And you saw no fruits.
Et vous avez vu aucune semence.
And then God now begins to provide.
Et Dieu commence à pourvoir.
Peter.
Pierre,
launch your net.
Jette les filets.
And when Peter launched the net,
et quand Pierre a lancé les filets,
he caught fish.
Il a attrapé des
poissons. It was a miracle.
C'était un miracle.
It was not by his skills.
Ce n'était pas par ses habiletés.
It was not by his ability.
Ce n'était pas par ses talents.
It was not the works of his hands.
Ce n'était pas l'ouvrage de ses mains.
It was a miraculous provision.
C'était une provision.
I prophesy that kind of miraculous provision.
Je prophétise de ce genre de provision miraculeuse.
I say I prophesy it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh non,
I said
yeah,
on Wednesday.
Mercredi,
I saw this miraculous provision.
Il a vu cette provision miraculeuse.
I saw people.
Il a vu des
receiving
gens
cars they didn't deserve.
Qui recevaient des autos qui ne méritaient pas.
A gift.
Des dons.
I saw somebody.
Il a vu quelqu'un
receiving the keys of a house.
Recevoir le don d'une
you
maison.
Didn't qualify.
Qui n'était pas éligible.
I saw somebody.
J'ai vu quelqu'un
receiving money.
Recevoir
you
de
didn't
l'argent.
Qualify for.
Dont vous n'étiez pas
a
qualifié.
Miraculous provision.
Amen. Une provision.
Receive
miraculeuse.
It in the name of Jesus.
Recevez au nom
it
de
shall
Jésus.
Come to pass.
Ça va s'accomplir.
By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Par la puissance
lift
du
up your two hands.
Levez
the Lord fill your hands with provisions.
Avec des
there will be no lack in your house.
De
where there was a delay, I command it to be released. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Multiple provisions. Multiple provisions. Multiple provisions.
Provision
no, when I'm doing prophetic declaration, don't leave everybody. Leave, stand up. No, no, no. Don't focus on yourself, brother. When I'm doing prophetic declaration, don't distract anybody. Let him just focus on himself. You focus on yourself. Don't touch anybody. Amen. Everybody should focus. Amen. Because that is just distracting him. This is ministration. It can distract him not to receive. Amen. Lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. In the name of Jesus. I prophesy to you. Your hand shall be filled. Lift up your hands, everybody. I said, everybody, lift up. Your hand shall be filled. Your hand shall be filled. Your hand shall be filled. Your hands will not bring sorrow to you. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I command the blessings of God to come down on your hands. Father, fill their hands. Fill their hands. Fill their hands. With favor, with money, with wealth, with opportunities. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. One. Receive it. Two. Receive it. Three. In Jesus' name. Say, I receive it. Celebrate the Lord if you believe that.
Célébrez le Seigneur. Célébrez.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Your hand will be filled.
Vos mains seront remplies.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Go in the peace of the Lord.
Allez dans la paix.
Now, if you have any pain, that hand that has been lifted up, put it there and you will see healing there.
Si vous avez la douleur quelque part, mettez la main qui a été levée.
In the name of Jesus.
Vous allez voir la guérison.
Father, let them go in the peace of the Lord.
Qui vont dans la paix.
Surround them with your power.
Entoure-les de ta
puissance. Surround them with your glory.
Entoure-les de ta
surround them with your strength.
Entoure-les de
let favor go with them.
Que la faveur
in the name of Jesus.
Au nom
in
de
this
Jésus.
Covenant season of provision,
dans cette saison de
let provision never cease.
Que la provision ne
let provision flow.
Que la provision
in the name of Jesus.
Au nom de
by
Jésus.
The power of God. No death
Dieu.
Shall be heard in your house.
Death
no death shall be heard in the church.
Aucune
no death shall be heard in what you do. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, people, celebrate Jesus.
Célébrez Jésus.
Celebrate Jesus.
Célébrez
God
Jésus.
Bless you.
Que Dieu vous
thank
bénisse.
You for coming.
Merci d'être
have
venu.
A blessed week.
Amen.
Amen. Greet somebody and tell the person the bigger picture because there is continuous provision.
À la personne, il y a une plus grande image parce qu'il y a la provision.
Who are the two people who brought the envelope here? Where are they? Come, come, come.